Welcome back to Ericsson's live coverage of Mobile World Congress in Los Angeles. I'm Teresa Wolke, and I'm excited to be joined by Frederick Yedling, our head of business area networks for Ericsson. Thank you so much for joining us, Frederick.
Thank you for inviting me here. Great to be here.
Wonderful. So 2019 has been the year of 5G rollouts.
Yes.
What is Ericsson's standing, our leadership in this area?
Well, I think at this stage, we are live in 20 networks across the world, and we were actually first to launch in four continents across the world. When you reflect upon it, it's quite interesting. A year back when we were here in a similar chair, so to speak, we had just launched the first network with Verizon. It's actually been live for 1 year. But I would say it's still very early on in the development of 5G, in the deployment of 5G. We're learning a lot as we move along, and it's interesting also to reflect on that. We originally designed 5G to be ready to be launched by 2020 Olympics in Japan. Mm-hmm. Now, we as an industry pulled it back quite significantly, year and a half. We will continue, like all new technology, we'll continue to evolve it over time. But I would say that Ericsson has had a really, really good start. I think the best way to evaluate our performance, our leadership, is to ask customers. And we do get very, very positive feedback on the performance of our networks and the way we've approached it. So first inning is done. A lot of innings remain. So we'll lean forward and try to do even better than we've done so far.
Wonderful. And with all of these rollouts, what are some of the lessons that we've learned?
Well, I think one of them internally is that this is a launch that is completely different to that we did with 4G. With 4G, we had one band with one customer, and then we scaled it. Now it's a big scale across mid-band, low-band, and high-band across four continents at the same time. So that poses a lot of challenges to our ability to ramp the required resources in the development units to be able to meet all the market requirements. So I think it's a really proliferation around bands and spectrum that we need to deal with at the same time. So we're constantly evolving ourselves. How can we deal with that challenge through modularity and scalability? I think in the eyes of the customer, of course, and the end customer, they're still, to be honest, very relatively limited rollout. I would say that Korea is probably the market which has the biggest coverage where you can start drawing early conclusion about what 5G means. I think if we look in consumers, if we start talking to consumers, particularly in Korea, on what is done with AR, VR applications early on, I think it's been becoming a very positive experience for consumers.
All right. Well, speaking of use cases, we have a number of use cases that we're showing here at Mobile World Congress.
Yeah.
What are some of the ones that interest you the most?
Well, I think it's always like this. When you start a new business, it's good to do what you know how to do. And I think we know as an industry to do consumer mobile broadband. And some of the early applications in Korea, for example, how AI and VR has been introduced in the networks and the applicability of that for consumers is very interesting. Then I got a little bit of self-interest in that, of course, as well, because we're building up a factory here, a manufacturing plant here in Dallas, in the US. And that we will do fully automated with 5G. So fully automated manufacturing and also distribution out to site will be integrated and automated, utilizing 5G as a base platform for connectivity. So there's going to be the early indication of consumers is very attractive and interesting, I think. We have use cases we drive internally. We drink our own Kool-Aid. But there is probably so much more exciting stuff that I can't even think of, or you can't even think of, that's going to happen in 5G. So very positive early signs on this.
Absolutely, it's very exciting. So speaking of exciting news, we announced a partnership with NVIDIA this week. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, so we've been looking a little bit. There's a strong demand, if we start with the customer, which is always helpful. There is a demand for being able to utilize the full ecosystem around cloud, around COTS, and these type of technologies, be more efficient and develop an overall innovative platform end-to-end. Virtualization is a key technology in being able to enable that. And for us, it's so that if we have customers that require something from our network, we need to be the first one to develop that and listen to our customers. Parallel to that, there is a technology now that we've seen with NVIDIA around GPUs utilized as accelerators that can be utilized to drive this, and it's a technology that can bring up the performance, the flexibility and deployment options of 5G to the level we haven't seen before. So that customer drive, we now find a very promising technology that we will evaluate together with NVIDIA over time here to see how we can build the next generation 5G virtualized RAN networks.
All right, well, looking forward to next year, 2020, where do you think we will go with 5G?
It's a very good question. I think the first thing when you do, there's an early deployment of limited deployment of 5G. What we're going to see, if you're an Ericsson customer, of course, you're going to be able to turn on 5G utilizing the installed 4G base through what we call Ericsson Spectrum Sharing. In addition to that, there's going to be a deeper penetration of capacities on both the mid and high band to be able to offer better, faster, more ubiquitous 5G services across. So that's one thing. You're going to see it happening in more places, more countries, and deeper down into the networks. But I also think we're going to start seeing far more real industrial use cases coming along. And here I've been speaking to a lot of people, a lot of customers, and we start to see the development of use cases that start making sense for 5G that is built upon the characteristics of 5G in terms of latency and speed. So I think we're going to start in 2020 to see more, so to speak, real use cases out of 5G coming along.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for sharing all of your insights.
You.
Fredrik Hjelding, Head of Business Area Networks for Ericsson. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much, Risa. Thank you.
All right. Thanks for watching.